Well, thank you very much. I was hoping to have majority in front of that, but
yeah, majority give us two more years.
Yeah,
right. let's talk a little bit about what this new Congress is going to look like, though, because it's something that investors and business people are watching very closely. What Maxine Waters said yesterday did rattle the markets. All of the ideas about weakening regulation or rolling back regulation that have taken place over the last couple of years, she says that's going to end right now. What do you think?
Well, we're going to be in a divided government. The uniqueness that I'm seeing, though, is it seems like all the old players are coming back, that the old leadership. You got Nancy Pelosi, Steny Hoyer and Clyburn. You've got Maxine Waters. The difference, though, is it's not like when they had control of the Senate and the presidency. Now it's different. Republicans are still in the majority in the Senate, a little stronger, and you got President Trump. That's why you had these economic changes in the last 2 years. So I think they'll try, but they will not be successful. But that means government will be a little more divided. We'll have to find ways to unite, but I don't think Maxine Waters' ideas are things that will unite and become successful.
Do things come to a halt in Washington as a result of the change in leadership in the House?
Well, we'll have to wait to see. The Democrats are still trying to decide who's going to become their speaker. If their agenda is really about just investigations, I think America's too great to have such a small agenda or a vision. So I still think their majority will be smaller than our majority. So they're going to have a lot of challenges. They're going to be sitting in seats, 16 of them, that President Trump won. So I still believe we may be sitting in the minority, but we're going to have a very good chance here to be able to, working with the Senate, to still make those tax cuts permanent for the middle class, to find ways to find common ground when it comes to infrastructure. I still think, when you look just yesterday at the criminal justice reform, we're still in power here till January. There's still a number of things we will be able to do, but we'll have to wait to see what the Democrat leadership holds. If it's the same old leadership as the past, I don't think they'll be very successful.
Leader McCarthy, let's just play this out. As you mentioned, we don't know exactly who is going to be leading things. Nancy Pelosi looks likely, although she doesn't have the 218 votes needed at this point. And there are some voices that are popping up in her party that could potentially prevent that. You know what it's like to deal with a party that where not everybody is moving in the same step. You've been dealing with that for quite a while yourself. It seems to me that Pelosi has kind of signaled that her way of leadership would not necessarily be to focus simply on investigations. However, she does have a lot of voices in her party that would like to see just that happen. What kind of fine line is she going to be walking in terms of wanting to potentially reach out and make some deals across the table, and then also trying to answer to all the voices in her own party?
Look, I know the difficulty of trying to get to become speaker. You have to have 218 on the floor. They have a number of people who ran who said they would never vote for her. But they're coming from the minority to the majority. Normally, if that happens, the leader always usually becomes speaker. But having been it before, and I disagree with you, because the things I hear from Congresswoman Pelosi, it's a lot about investigation. If you listen to Nadler sitting on the train, it's all about investigations, right? That's really what their focus has been. They did not lay out an agenda for the American public. Look, we have a lot of places and rooms for improvement. There's not one reason why we lost. If you look, history was against us. On average, when a new president comes in, you lose 30-some seats. History played exactly the course. We had more retirements than ever before, outspent by $150 million. Michael Bloomberg's money went a long ways. I mean, he defeated a lot of people by writing those $5 million checks. So we do have rooms for improvement, but they did not win by laying out an agenda like a pledge to America or a contract with America. When you talk to them about what they're going to do in January, they think they need to get together to think about their agenda. So the only thing they've talked about is investigating the president, trying to get a tax return, and talking about impeachment. Our country's too great for that.
What ground do you think there could be common ground? I mean, people have thrown out ideas like infrastructure. Do you think that's realistic, though? Because there are all sorts of disagreements between the two parties and even within each party about how to pay for that.
Well, that's going to be the real hang-up when it comes to infrastructure. How do we pay for it? And if we have the will, we could come together. Again, we just did criminal justice. We found the ability to do that. We found a number of ways that we could, when we were in power right now, that we were successful at different things. It's going to have to wait to see what their leadership. If Nancy Pelosi is the same Nancy Pelosi in the past, she's not very good at working across the aisle. She doesn't allow her members to work across the aisle. If she was to fall and Steny Hoyer became speaker, I think the world would be different. But remember, she also has a new group group coming in that is much more left, that many have all identified as socialism. One of the newest members went to her office not to sit down and meet with her, but to join the protesters. That is a little crazy.
There's an election coming up. I keep saying that. People always go, because it's the.
I know,
but it is intended. The irony is intended. Obviously, it is. So all these newly elected House Democrats that you have are going to be up in 2 years. And my only point is that if they really do keep pushing things like single payer, I think that's number one on their list is single payer. I'm not sure I think they got the independents this time for whatever reason that, the pendulum does swing back and forth. We know about that with midterms. But they got 2 years. And if that's the true colors of what we're going to see, this far left, sit-in climate change agenda, you'll have a chance in this next election. They could be one-termers, theoretically, a leader if you play things right. But I don't know.
It's always better to win an election on ideas. Not on resistance. Because
ideas. Single payer. Where is the country on single payer, do you think? Where is the country?
I think if you poll the question, it'll be split kind of 50-50. Then if you go into the details, though, 55% of Americans get their health care through their company. That would be wiped away. The VA would be wiped away. So once you really had the debate about it, I think they would lose. Look, healthcare became a number one issue in this election, but it wasn't the idea that the American public wanted single payer. They didn't talk about the factors in it. And the places that they won were in these suburban areas. I think they would be one of the first people to lose. If they overstretch and they really go to what the core of the new people come in wanting to impeach the president, that will only guarantee the reelection of President Trump. Right. So if they overstep their bounds, I think they'll be in trouble. And they're finding that they can't even put their leadership team together. That's going to be a struggle. And it's going to take some time.
Leader, I want to get your thoughts on a headline that just crossed literally within the last hour. Saudi Arabia is saying that they are going to seek the death penalty for five different members of the murdering team, dare I say, that killed Khashoggi. What do you think the relationship should be between the United States and Saudi Arabia? Bolton has now tried to say that he doesn't think that MBS had anything to do with it or that it wasn't conclusive. Your colleague, Lindsey Graham, has said that MBS is toxic, says that he can never be a world leader and should never be trusted.
I think the only way to handle this situation is transparency. You've got to have a fair process. You've got to get all the facts out there. And I think time will only tell.
But who do you believe? I mean, the problem is that there's a lot of skepticism about the investigation that's gone on, or at least what you're hearing out of Saudi Arabia. They've changed their story now 5, 6, 7 times. And meanwhile, you have a problem even in the White House because of the relationships that the president and some of his family members have with MBS personally.
Well, I would wait and say, that headline you just read, I don't think that headline would have came to fruition if this administration was not being tough on Saudi Arabia. So let's be honest with the work that's being done. I think our Secretary of State is doing an amazing job here. So I would not jump to conclusions, but if you keep changing your story, you've got a real problem on your hands. And I think America, using their diplomacy of what they're dealing with, and also knowing the region, of being able to manage the entire region at the same time. But the number one thing America has always stood for is about the rule of law, honesty, and transparency. And I think we'll continue to drive to make that happen. This is not something that's going to go away by any means. This is something that the entire world is looking at. And if you keep changing your story, I don't think you're going to be successful at the end.